What's up, duders? It's Val Dudes coming at you with a little live commentary here. I got my wheel set up, my pedal set up down here. Gonna be doing a little project cars here with the BMW Z4 GT3. This car sounds absolutely beast. We're gonna be driving it at Bathurst here. So let's get right into it. Just three laps, just me driving around. Just kind of showing you guys a little bit more of the project cars and Bathurst, since, you know, the Bathurst 1000 is this weekend, and it was just announced that it's going to be officially in Gran Turismo, so I know everybody's super excited about that, so let's get it going here. Let's listen to this engine rev here, duders. Oh, yeah. This engine sound is so good. I don't even care if it's perfectly accurate. All I know is that it sounds way better than Gran Turismo in its current state. Well, at least the Gran Turismo 6 videos that we've been seeing of this exact same car in Gran Turismo. I mean, if you compare the two side by side, I'm not going to do that. You know, I could do that as a video, but I'm not going to do that. But if you listen to them side by side, seriously, like, what is going on? Like, I mean, I guess I have faith in the new sound system that Gran Turismo is working on, even though we really don't know what it's going to sound like. I mean, we heard those sounds that were in that Bathurst trailer. We've heard those before, those kind of engine sounds in another trailer that they did. And, you know, those sound great and all, but we don't know if that's what's going to be really in the game. Shit. Losing it. Contact this lap time will not be recorded. Yeah, dude, see, that's the thing here with project cars is, you know, I'm always like adjusting wheel settings, like doing different things, because it's the physics are just never quite on for me, honestly. There's something about like Gran Turismo's physics and iRacing's physics that are just like super polished. It feels super nice. Like in a lot of these other sims, like, it's hard to feel like when the car is like breaking away and losing grip. Like in Gran Turismo, I really feel really well when the tail end is losing its grip and I can counter steer and know what's going on. But, you know, maybe my wheel's just getting too old. I've been using this wheel since the beginning of Gran Turismo 5, so that's well over 2 years. And with the way I abused the wheel and turn it so hard, you know, it's definitely lost some of its vigor when I first got it, but it's a lot more loose. It doesn't snap back to the center as tight as it used to. So I'm not sure if it's partly, you know, my wheel is just losing it, or these games just don't have as professional physics as, you know, some of the other bigger titles out there. Well, iRacing isn't that big of a title, but they've totally dedicated themselves to providing that real race experience, so they've worked extra hard on things like the modeling of the race cars and tire models, physics and all that. Yeah, I'm not sure what all the different names of the sections here are at Bathurst. You know, I'm not familiar with the track, other than driving it in Project Cars, you know, and watching the random Bathurst highlights clip on YouTube here there. But I mean, just listen to these sounds once again. I love how they have just so much personality. It really feels like the car is this alive, creaking, snorting, screaming animal. It doesn't feel like such a static, just generic shift up, shift down, or even when you're braking. You hear like all the metal in the car just clanking against itself, and all the sounds of just raw machinery at work. This section is insane. You have to be braking so well, so early down into it, or else you spin out coming around that little right-hander. Whoa, whoa, it's too hot. You can see I have the little pedal cam going. You can see the crazy pedal work that I have to do to just try not to stabilize the car to keep it balanced. And here, other things about Project Cars. Here, let's look at this. Like the little Motec information display down there, I can switch between lap splits, fuel, tire temperatures, brake temperature. Really cool that they have that level of simulation built into it. And you can change the time of day to any time of day that you want. I usually like the early morning to late evening type of times like this, magic hour times. Move to our last lap here. Oh, just lost it there. Quick counter steer. Water. Now the leaves here on the track, these are cool, because when you drive over them, you'll see during the replay, or if you're in a different car behind, they kind of fly up as you expect them to, as the car just whizzes past them. And some beautiful, crazy lens flare there. Whoa. Almost losing it again. You don't want to come into any of these turns like way too tight. Way too fast, I mean. Because that just totally loosens up the car as the momentum of the rear just keeps going in front of you. Maybe if I adjusted the brake balance. See, that's the thing. You can do all kinds of setup adjustments in Project Cars, but it's taken me forever just to figure out how the physics and everything feels just regularly that I wouldn't even know where to start with the adjustments to make anything better. You know, probably on the brake bias, like I said there, but I think that's another thing you can just adjust in car. With, you just have to map the button to one of the controls, for example, on my Logitech Driving Force GT here, and then you should be good. Should be able to change that on the fly. Alright, going back down the hill here. Nice, gears. Yeah, I can't wait for Gran Turismo 6 to just finally come out. I mean, seems like the wait for that game is just painful. Gonna be so excited when it does finally come out. We're gonna be doing so many videos of it, live streams. Oh yeah, dudes, and I always forget to tell everybody in the videos to go check out my t-shirt shop. I have one, you know, for American region, UK, and Greater Europe. Spreadshirt kind of divides it up into different stores like that, but yeah, like this derp shirt that I'm wearing right now with the monkeys on there, got a bunch of other designs in there, dudes, but hold on, let's just scope out the replay right from here. Anyway, yeah, so once again, another Project Cars video here, dudes. Like, these replays look great, the graphics are great. Well, the replays are kind of wonky, you know, they're not as solid as Gran Turismo. Look, it even has a little Gran Turismo banner on the top of it there. That's pretty funny. But yeah, just a great sounding game. I mean, that's when I want to get my good car sound fix. I'll come play this game and like really just savor each little downshift and upshift. That's why the sounds are such an important part of a game. You know, I see people on the forums or different websites saying like, oh, whatever, like, just as long as the physics are good, like, sounds, whatever. No, to me, it's at least 50% of the equation, like, because if you have crappy sounds pulling you out of the experience, that's not good. I mean, that's a huge part of cars, is the exhaust sound, and the downshifts, and the upshifts, and the burbles and crackles of a car engine, and it's really disappointing that you don't really hear any of that in Gran Turismo 6, but hopefully they'll be working on that. I mean, the community is being ridiculously loud about this, about the sounds. Like, there's no way that they don't know that we want beautiful sounds. So, oh, there's my little accident into the front there. That's another thing, like, with Project Cars, like, the damage modeling is incredible. Like, if I kept crashing this, you know, the front nose piece, the hood would come off, and everything underneath that would be perfectly rendered. The engine would all be there. Every little part is still there. Oh, there go the leaves that I was talking about. They're gonna fly up there. Oh, there's the replays kind of switching between weird angles, but let's watch this replay for this whole lap here. And Neuters, if you haven't come to the Val live streams and you want to, you know, you're thinking about, oh, is it worth my time or just whatever? Like, this is kind of how the live streams go. You know, just this format. I'll have, like, my webcam, maybe the foot cam, but yeah, we'll just run some laps, run some little free practice sessions in Gran Turismo, and maybe play some other games. Lately, I've been doing Grand Theft Auto, Grand Theft Auto 5, but yeah, this is kind of how they go. So if you're wondering, there, the upshift sound sounds like you really hear the gearbox going like that kind of deep, low-end sound. Front nose is still hanging on there. Oh, this is a beautiful shot. Then coming around the little kink here. Even got some rubber marbles on the side of the track, off the line there. Good spark. Just a beautiful game. That's why I'm just kind of bummed that the physics isn't up to par as the graphics and everything. I mean, it still has its own crazy physics engine. It's just difficult to read, like I said, when the car is like breaking loose and the rear's coming out. So anyway, dudes, hope you like this little kind of live commentary Project Cars video here. Just a way for me to make videos more quickly and get them out to you with more frequency. So I hope you like the format. It's not as polished as my multicam editing and all that, but let me know how you liked it, dudes. And yeah, I'll see you on the next one. Until then, it's Val Dudes, signing out.